Good morning, students. I hope you all understood the first part of Geography Lesson 4, that is India Resources and Industries. Students, before entering into the lesson, please note down all the points which is presented in this video. Then only you can revise and understand the continuity of the lesson. In last class, we saw about the definition of resources and types of resources. In this class, we are going to see the different types and distribution of industries in India and the major problems of Indian industry. Students, before entering into the lesson, we just recall our previous portion. What is resources? Resources is any matter or energy derived from the environment that is used by living things including human. So that is, resources means the material which is taken from the earth and also useful to human beings, that is called resources. This resources is classified into two major groups. One is renewable resources, another one is non-renewable resources. Renewable means it can be produced within a short period. Non-renewable means it takes long period to replace that minerals in the earth. Next, minerals. Mineral is a natural substance of organic or inorganic origin with definite chemical and physical property. Mineral is classified into two major groups. One is metallic mineral, another one is non-metallic mineral. Metallic mineral means the mineral which contain metal in their ore form. Non-metallic mineral means the mineral which do not contain metallic in their ore form. Next, mining. Mining is extraction of minerals from the earth. That process is called mining. This mining is classified into two types. One is open pit mining. It is the minerals will be taken from the crust of the earth. Next, shaft mines. It will be taken underground. Okay, let's start our today's portion. Industries. Industries. Industries refers to the activities which converts the raw material into finished products. This sector is also called value addition sector. On the basis of the source of raw materials, industries are classified into agro-based industries, forest-based industries and mineral-based industries. This agro-based industries is further divided into large-scale agro-industries, medium-scale agro-industries, small-scale agro-industries based on their size of the industry. Let's see one by one. Agro-based industries. Agro-based industries are those industries which depend on agricultural products as their raw materials. For example, cotton textile industries use cotton as raw material and then process them to make dresses. So cotton is cultivated in agriculture field. So based on that raw material, such industries are called agro-based industries. So cotton industry comes under agro-based industries. Let's see what are the processes involved in the cotton industry. Cotton textile industry. Cotton is a crop which is cultivated in black soil. It is the most important raw material used in the textile industry. It is collected in a one place. Cotton is converted into cloth and this cloth material is used to make dresses, t-shirts, curtains and many other things which we use in our daily life. Let us look into the process that are involved in the making of a cotton cloth. First, cotton balls are plucked from the cotton plant. Next, they are cleaned and then supplied to the textile industry in large quantities. Then The cotton is then used to make threads. They give colors to the threads and it is fitted in the weaving machine. Weaving is the most basic process in which two different sets of yarns or threads are interlaced with each other to form a fabric or cloth. Modern weaving machines make the cloth at a very fast pace. It reduces cost and time. And also, it gives lot of designs in the dresses. Now you know that cotton is the main raw material used in textile industries. Next, the important process involved in the process of cotton is ginning. Ginning is the process of separating cotton seed from cotton. So ginning is the process of separating cotton seed from cotton. It is taken into the large stand, then it is washed and the seeds are removed. This process is called ginning. This is your important 2 mark. Ginning is the process by which the fibers are separated from the seeds. Is called ginning. Here fiber means cotton. It is one of the most important step of the spinning process. After collecting the seed cotton from the field, cotton moves to nearby gins for separation of lint, seed and any other foreign particles. So this process is called ginning. The first cotton mill in India was established in 1818 at Fort Gloucester near Kolkata, but was a commercial failure. It was banned. The leading cotton producing states is Mumbai. So it is called Manchester of India. According to Tamil Nadu, Coimbatore is called as Manchester of South India. Next, silk industry. India has been making silk fabrics in Bengal and Kashmir for centuries. Sericulture is the rearing of silkworm. So the process of rearing of silkworm is called sericulture. It is a labor intensive industry. That is, lot of labor involved for the process of silk production. And it provides employment to people in the rural areas. India produces mulberry silk. There are some other varieties are also available. They are tussar, eri, muga. These are produced in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Orissa, Bihar, Jharkhand, Assam and Meghalaya. So this is the process of making silk. So the cocoon will secrete some thread-like material around their body. So these are the cocoons. After some time, it will be harvested. So these are the cocoons for the making of silk. Then it is undergone some process. First it is washed. Then the thread is separated by some rolling equipments. So by this method only the silk is separated from the cocoons. So, the process of removing the silk thread fibers from the cocoons of the silkworm is known as reeling. So, what is reeling means? The process of removing the silk thread fibers from the cocoons. This is the process in which different types of equipment and machineries are used to separate the fibers from the wound cocoon and wind it in the form of long thread. So, Karnataka is the largest producer of silk. The other major producers of silk are Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, Jammu and Kashmir, so on. Next, sugarcane industry. It is also a agro-based industry. Let's see what are the processes involved in the production of sugar. Sugarcane from the field is weighed in a weighing bridge. Then, weighed cane from the weigh bridge is unloaded into the feeder table. So it is taken for weight machine. Then it is dropped into cane carrier, which carries the sugar cane for preparation. It is prepared by the preparatory device. They are cane kicker, cane leveler, and cane fibrizer. So this is called cane kicker. This is called cane leveler. This is called cane fibrizer. So the prepared can, it's look like this only. So you see it in the sugarcane juice shop. Prepared can from the fibrizer is taken to milling tandem by rack carrier. So it is the process for carrying the sugar cane into the next process. Then the prepared can passes through four consecutive mills. Each mill consists of three cylindrical rollers. Next, all the four mills are driven by powerful power supply. Hot water is added at discharge of third mill to extract maximum sugarcane juice from the bagasse. Final discharge of bagasse from fourth mill is carried to boiler through rack elevator. So by the help of rack elevator, it is transferred to final boiler. Then the five feeder of boiler feeds bagasse into furnace. Excess bagasse are dropped at yard. Later it will be used during mill stoppages. Extracted juice mixed with water is sent to the boiling house for further processing. This juice is heated in juice heater at 70 degrees Celsius. Then, in order to bleach and maintain pH of the juice, it is treated with milk of lime and sulfur dioxide. Because of this sulfur dioxide only, it looks like white color. The treated juice is then further heated at 108 degrees Celsius. Then the juice goes into the clarifier tank. It takes over 2 hours to settle. Impurities falls to the bottom of the tank. The settled mud is pumped to rotary vacuum filters where the mud is filtered from the juice. So the filtered juice is returned to process further while the pressed mud cake remains outside the drum out of. As there is no waste in sugar industry, this pressed mud cake is used as manure in sugar cane field. The clarified juice, that is the purified juice collected from the clarifier tank. This brings the concentration of sugar up from 15% to 17%. The syrup is treated with sulfur dioxide gas. The sulfated syrup is pumped to vacuum pans for further concentration and formation of sugar grains. The microscopic sucrose crystal is poured into the syrup to develop crystal inside. Formation of sugar crystals inside the vacuum pans. So this is the formation of crystals. As the water in the syrup boils away, workers regularly check how the sugar is crystallized. So this is the crystallized form of sugar juice. Once the crystal reaches its desired size, it is dropped down to the centrifugal machine. Centrifugal machine is look like a washing machine. Loading of dropped muscate from crystallizer. So this is the centrifugal machine. This machine operates between 50 to 1100 RPM, which draws the molasses to outer shell of the machine. Hot water is sprayed inside the basket to wash crystals, then only it will get white color. The separated molasses from the basket is taken to the pan section for reprocess. So to again remove the impurities, it is goes other process. Sugar crystals inside the basket is dropped at the hopper, then goes to the dryer. Hot air is blown into the dryer to remove moisture content from the sugar crystals. Dry sugar from the dryer is taken to the grader by the bucket conveyor. Here powder sugar is graded down. Sugar with standard size are carried to sugar storage bin. Finally, the sugar is bagged in PP bag of 50 kg. So, this is the process involved in the production of sugar. So, sugar is produced from the sugar cane, which is cultivated in the agriculture field. So sugar industry is also comes under agro based industry. The next type of industry is jute industry. History of jute. Jute has been used since ancient times in Africa and Asia to provide a cordage and weaving fiber from the stem and wood from the leaves. In several historical documents during the era of the great Mughal Emperor Akbar, states that the poor villages of India used to wear cloths made of jute. Jute is a natural fiber with golden and silky shine. Because of the golden color, it is also called the golden fiber. It is your important one mark, children. Jute is also called golden fiber. It is the cheapest vegetable fiber procured from the bast or skin of the plant stem, and the second most important vegetable fiber after cotton in terms of usage, global consumption, production and availability. It has high tensile strength, low extensibility, and ensures better breathability of fabrics. Jute fiber is 100% biodegradable and recyclable, thus environmentally friendly. Jute is the second most important industry next to cotton textile and plays a dominant role in the industrial economy of eastern India. India is the largest producer and second largest exporter of jute products in the world. Bangladesh provides over 90% of the world raw jute fiber export. So next to Bangladesh, India is the largest exports of jute fiber. So these are the state which produce jute in our country. The leading jute producer state is West Bengal. Next, forest-based industries. Forest-based industries means the industries which depend the raw materials taken from the forest. For example, furniture industry. So, for the making of furniture, they need wood. The wood will be taken from the forest. So, such kind of industries is called forest-based industries. The another example for forest-based industries is paper industry. So, the paper is made from the pulp of the plant. So, it is also comes under forest-based industries. The basic raw materials for the production of paper is wheat straw, bagasse bamboo, cotton linter, rice straw, cotton stalk, grasses, etc. But nowadays, due to the increasing regulation and raw material prices, the companies are increasingly using more non-wood based raw materials over the years. So nowadays, the industries, the paper industries, recycle the paper about 38%. Only 32% of industries use wood as a raw material. Production of paper in West Bengal is the highest because raw material for the industry, that is bamboo, is abundantly available in the state. So bamboo is the basic raw material for the production of paper. So the bamboo availability is the main reason for the production of paper in West Bengal. Moreover, the neighboring state of Assam also provides bamboo in large amount to West Bengal. The next type of industry is mineral-based industry. Mineral-based industries that receive raw materials primarily from minerals such as iron and steel, cement factory, aluminium industry, copper smelting industry. So, mineral-based industries depend on the minerals from the earth. Iron ore is the basic mineral of many industries. Iron and steel industry is called the basic metallurgical industry as its finished products is used as raw materials by a host of other industries. This type of industries also help to improve the economic development of country. Next, automobile industry. India is set to emerge not only as a large domestic market for automobile manufacturers, but also as a crucial link in the global automotive chain. It is one of the most dynamic industrial group in India. Some of the automotive companies in India are: the major Indian companies is Ashok Leyland, Tata, TVS, Mahindra, so on. The major multinational companies which is present in our country is Toyota, Renault, Audi, Honda, so on. Next, electrical and electronic industry. heavy electrical industries manufacture equipments used for power generation, transmission and utilization. The electronic industry is made up of companies that manufacture, design, manufacture, assemble and service electronic products, etc. Bengaluru is the largest producer of electronic goods in India, hence it is called the electronic capital of India. Next, software industry. India is home to some of the finest software companies in the world. The software companies in India are reputed across the globe for their efficient IT and business related solution. Some of the IT companies present in our country are Tata Consultancy, Wipro, Infosys, etc. Next, the major challenges of Indian industry, that is wealth creation and sharing, create jobs. So, based on the education, that company has to create new kinds of jobs. Next, balanced regional development. So, the company is also responsible for the regional development. Next, GDP and per capita income. Based on the GDP, the company also produces that much of production. Next, standard of living. Next, entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship means organization. So, the leadership. Next, exports. So, the company has to increase the amount of exports to some other countries. Next, community development. So, without community development, the company does not improve to reach their goal. Students, I hope you all understood this lesson. Here I gave some evaluation. Try to answer this question. That is, define agro-based industry, define mineral-based industry, differentiate jute industry and sugar industry, describe the major challenges of Indian industries. Thank you.